Research shows that long COVID is disproportionately affecting Latinos. And to find out why and what's being done to address the issue, we welcome Gilberto Lopez, who's with the ASU School of Trans-Border Studies. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
All right, before we get started, define long COVID. What is it?
So long COVID can be defined, the CDC recently defined it as lingering symptoms of COVID well beyond a negative test. So it could be a weeks, it could be months, it could be years, but same symptoms as with COVID, just lingering for longer after you have.
But there are a lot of questions regarding a definition because it seems to be a diagnosis of elimination.
Correct. There's many different definitions along COVID, but I think in short, what it is, it's a combination of different symptoms that are connected to COVID and that keep lingering. There's not one or two precise definitions, but the idea is that it's this lingering effect of COVID, winded, brain fog, muscle aches, being tired more often.
Hitting the Latino community extra hard. What's going on there?
Yeah, so we saw that COVID-19 disproportionately hit the Latino community in many different ways, specifically in transmission rates, in infections, and in death. So we saw that affecting the Latino community disproportionately more than other groups. And so we're seeing that with long COVID as well. Long COVID, it's affecting Latino community specifically hard.
Multi-generational homes, could that be a factor?
There's many different factors, many that fall under that idea of the social determinants of health. Where we live, where we work, and where we play affect our vulnerability to health. Living in like you mentioned, in housing with many different generations or more crowded conditions made it more difficult for people to socially distance. Thus, more likely to get COVID, and thus more likely to have long COVID, the effects of COVID.
So the long COVID numbers kind of mirror the COVID numbers.
Correct, and that's what we hypothesize. That's what's going on with the Latino community. Because they had such high rates, then the effects of long COVID are lingering. And added to that, the other socioeconomic dimension of not having health insurance at the same rates, so people are not going to a doctor at the same rates, which makes it worse.
Talk about your efforts now to get information about long COVID out there and to address this issue.
Yeah, so we're doing a series of projects at the School of Transborder Studies, also the Southwest Interdisciplinary Research Center here at ASU. We have a couple projects, one being the COVID Latino campaign. It's a health communication campaign. The goal is to get this needlessly complex health information to the Latino community in ways that are easy to understand, easy to grasp, using the arts. And we use the arts, we use animations, artwork from renowned artists from across the Southwest, artists from here, the Phoenix area, to get this information to a community that's not getting it otherwise.
Are you getting a good response on this?
Yes, we got an incredible response. We're now launching the second wave of this campaign, focused specifically on long COVID. But we did studies on reach, and it seems like people really liked our messaging. It's easy to understand, and it's culturally tailored, and that's more important.
Yeah, indeed. For some communities, I don't know, maybe a Latino community, I don't know, you tell me, there's a thought out there that long COVID, it's all in your head. It's all psychological. Just buck up and let's get through it. Do you see that?
We see it. I think we did, we collected data, we did research on this, and the number one thing that we found was people have an idea that the symptoms I'm experiencing now, the shortness of breath, fatigue, brain fog, it's somehow connected to when I had COVID because it got worse after COVID. That connection is not clear in people's minds, and that's what we're trying to do. Make sure that people understand, know when to go to a doctor, when to know when something's not normal. But the idea is there that something happened after COVID, I don't know exactly what, and our messaging is trying to make that clear.
Yeah, well, yeah, and your messaging is doing a great job there. Gilberto, thank you so much for joining us, and best of luck, continued success. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.